Next up will be Bharat from physics on reading out the geometry from an atom's memory.
Okay, that timer is counting my 3 minutes. It has got an internal process going on which keeps track of the time. The old pendulum clocks had a pendulum moving back and forth which kept track of the time. Similarly, an atom has got its own little internal process which keeps track of the time. An atom is a clock. That's how atomic clocks work. That prompts an intriguing question. If atoms can remember the time, can they remember anything else? My thesis is about answering this question for a type of atoms. It is about reading out the memory of an atom to find out what do they remember besides the time. Now, there are two problems in doing this. First, atoms are so small, and second, they are moving around all the time. Fortunately, these atoms are also magnetic. They are like the little magnets that we all have played with. So that's why I've got an arrow drawn on each atom showing the magnet direction. So they can be held floating between two large magnets, and that's exactly what we do in our lab. We use laser beams to push these atoms and gather them between two large magnets where they are trapped. The atoms in the trap are still moving around very fast, and that's not good. We need to slow them down. In physics, temperature is connected to how fast the atoms are moving, so we can slow them down by cooling. We cool them down to a point where they almost stop moving. With trapped and cooled atoms, we are ready to do our experiment. We want to find out what do these atoms remember. So we should first take them for a ride and then ask them what they know about it. How do we take these atoms for a ride? If we bring another magnet near the atoms would sit in their place and turn around facing towards the magnet. That's because the atoms are themselves magnetic. If we take this magnet and move it around in a circle, the atoms would sit in their place and turn around. We can now talk to these atoms by making a measurement and ask them what they know about that circle. Of course, they know how long it took to complete the circle. That's why they're clocks. But apart from that, I found they also remember a geometrical area related to that object in golden yellow. It is an abstract mathematical object. And if you take the circle along which the magnet was moved and draw it on this object, it is going to enclose some area shaded in black. It turns out that it is this area that the atoms remember besides the time. That's significant because it's a part of the deep relationship between geometry and physics, the one recognized by Galileo, who said, "The nature is a book written in the language of mathematics, whose characters are triangles and circles." Thank you.
Our 10th and final presenter, so let's have a round. I'm sorry, let's let the judges deliberate here for a moment, and then we'll press on to the voting.